Come on in, guys. Here we go. Well, it must be nearly a year, I think, since I've last fished Port Talbot. It was this time last year when we were down here on a regular basis, before the COVID sort of took stronghold. And we ended up, unfortunately, not fishing it for quite a while. Now, the last couple of matches they've had down here, it's been fishing quite well with the roach, you know, which is just up my street. In fact, it's fishing so popular, it's attracted quite a lot of anglers from all over. A couple of Evesham boys here, Gloucester boys, as well as the Swansea and the Cardiff boys. Oh, and Bristol, there's Ivan. Yeah, so bit of a dank, miserable day, but let's hope it clears up, because my method, the waggler up in the water, might not work if it's too windy and rainy. Like, it needs to be a bit still. But seeing the boys are sorting their bait out, so I better go and pay the pools, I think. Hey, Paul! No lying now about your bloody weight.
Clive.
How are you?
We're going to be next to each other again.
I wouldn't mind. No.
You owe me one.
Yeah, I know. Ivan.
You're going to turn the rain off.
Oh, no, that's the trouble, isn't it? It was lovely yesterday. Look at it today.
Yeah. Yeah, man. Still nice to be out fishing, mate.
Yeah, of course it is, yeah. Well, this time last year, I'm just saying, this time last year, the COVID come and we stopped fishing down here then.
Yeah.
You know. Yeah, it'd be okay.
The bikes that we had on the Gloucester last week.
Oh, without a doubt, without a doubt. Hey, Richie! Richie!
Oh, come on, boy, got
yeah, I got two. You got loads of grub bait now.
Yeah.
I got two bags for you as well. I'll have it now. Hello, Dave. Yeah, that's what's just come in. A big ocean liner. Don't know whether he's dropping off or picking up. But that's the reason why there's a lot of mullet in here, because obviously they let these big ocean liners in, and I think the mullet follow them. Now, I think he's this guy's just, well, he's just turned up now. He's just starting to turn around, I think. What generally happens, a couple of things may happen. First of all, it may push the fish over to this side, which is one good thing. The bad thing is that obviously the lock was full, and now they'll probably release a lot of water, so you might find the level dropping a little bit. But as I say, well, he's just starting to maneuver now, turning round. I think he's trying to dock across there, where he's either dropping a load of aggregate or sand off or picking it up, one of the two. But as I say, it's a good thing in a way, because at least this dock is still being used, and you know, which bodes well for us fishing it, because a lot of docks these days have become redundant, and you know, the fishing, no fishing, or the fish disappear, and they fill a lot of these docks in. That's happened to Cardiff, you know, where I come from. A few of the docks there have been filled in over the years. There you go. And there's the steelworks, Port Talbot. There's Steve there, next to me. All right. Steve Shaw, next to me. He's a very good commercial angler, and he does well on you. He's a good feeder man. Who have I got next to him then? Oh, there's a guy named Gibbs. He's quite good on you for bream. And you've got Paul Waddington. Now, Paul's from Gloucester. And he's a very good angler, you know. As I say, he was next to me on the Gloucester last match. And he managed to get the better of me. So, well, let's have a look at this ship. Now it's turning over, turning around. What's it called? The Pauline B. Anyway, The rain's coming down now, so. Right, I'm peg 14. I've had a weight off, well, I've had a weight off all these pegs. That's where I had 53 pound off that peg. And one match. Yeah, completely turned around now, so I think he'll reverse and anchor up or tie themselves up, whatever they do. Yeah, so there we are. As I said, the ship's coming now, so I'm going to get prepped up in a minute. Starts at 10. We've got about an hour, so we've got plenty of time. My tack today, I'm not sure what to do, to be quite honest with you, because, as I said, I haven't fished here for a while, and I know Richie's been doing well on the whip. Clive Roberts won the match on the whip the week before. Of course, if the skimmers go, then I'm going to be hard-pressed to beat Steve next to me, so, because I'm definitely going to go for the roach to begin with. Probably on the waggler, the whip, and I'll put a little feeder down as well in case I'm struggling and I ended up, you know, it ends up feeder match. But hopefully, if this weather can stop raining, maybe, and not, you know, if the wind don't pick up, I should hopefully enjoy catching a few fish. But we'll see, you know, it's a learning curve. I've got another match here next week, so, yeah. So we'll see what happens anyway. Let's get tackled up and I'll show you what I'll be doing. Okay. Okay, it's a few minutes ago now. What I've done, I've set up a feeder, you know, taped up feeder, 20 gram. I've also set up two wagglers, one light, one slightly heavier, two Swan, three AAA, a whip on the inside, and a pole to hand on the inside. My method is knobs of ground bait for the first half hour, trying to get the roach on the waggler, and if that fails, then onto the skimmers, and I'll be feeding in the inside line as well. So, right, just gotta manipulate myself right here. Right, Steve's all ready to go. Yeah, always all ready to go. They're all joking. As I say, if the skimmers go, I'm going to get battered, but if the roach go, I've got a good chance. Right, this is interesting. I'm using an old microlite rod with a splice tip. I know it's probably sacrilege, the fact that I put a softer tip onto a microlite, but as I say, over the years, it's worked great for me. It's an old rod, this. So I've set that one up, and I got my cadence as well. Cadence 13 foot. Again, I've set up at about 6-7 foot deep, hoping to bring the fish up in the water, you know, because it's 20-22 foot deep. So that's my tactic there. I'm using, there's my feeder, my whip, and I got my pole to hand as well on this side. Got casters, got the maggots and ground bait. Now this is my new mix. It's a British, I call it a British mix because it's got all British ingredients in it. And I made it quite dry to begin with. If I had water, I could make it sloppy. So see how it goes, first of all. And is that it? That's it? Okay. Let's get going.
No.
Okay, which is over. Right, it's been one of them days today. Tried the waggler, tried the feeder, tried the poured hand. Just the odd fish here, there and everywhere. Apparently, it hasn't fished all that well. I think that there's been a bit of cold water influx, I think, with the bit of rain we've had this last couple of days. And it's actually come up about 6 inches, so, you know, it's not the best. Yeah, so, you know, I've caught half on the waggler and half on the feeder and a couple on the pole, but, you know, not a huge weight today. I expect somebody will have them somewhere, though, you know, they usually do. You know what match fishers are like. Sometimes, although people come in along the banks, they know it's not fishing very well and not much has been caught, you know. It's a good field today and there's some good anglers, so it wouldn't surprise me if, you know. I think they're paying the top five, so I don't think I got enough to get in the top five today, but never mind. Hey, it's always next week. As I say, it's been a long time since I've been here. I might be out of touch because I have been having a few matches here for the last month or so, and I've this is the first ticket I'd be able to get hold of, you know. So it's always next week. See what I can do next week. Anyway, go on there. Just wait for the scales now and I'll weigh in, see what I got. Okay, weighing in now, 8 pounds was the first. Nigel's on. He's had a big slap. But, you know.
No, I don't mind.
Just don't like it.
Oh, is that a pike in? I thought it looked a big weight then. Oh, dear.
You're
all
right, you weigh that in, don't you?
Fuck, I caught.
I've won the cup on the whip a couple of
Oh, that's a nice spring. Oh, that's where you need the day bonus fish.
That's all right, Ivan. Thank you, mate.
£20. The shot with that, I think, today. You caught?
No,
it's been one of them days today. It's a lot of cold water's coming, yeah. I think. You know.
Hello.
It's nuts for you.
One right there.
Stuart, yeah.
11-1.
Beefy for short. Yeah, he's caught all day there, fair to say.
No.
Oh, you spot on with these, anybody, Pop?
Bring your fish
up. Yeah, it's recording now, sir.
Anywhere.
What's best after the 21?
11, I think. 11-1. Oh, roach.
You better than Gloucester, Clive?
Yeah, well, definitely better than the Gloucester.
All on the Waggler Mini.
Wow, definitely.
Oh,
they're not going to go at the whole section of Gloucester.
I won't catch it in four matches. Season full of fish.
I don't know. I've had a £10 and a £7 on the Gloucester.
Oh, yeah,
Craig
11.
I'm on 12, Ron Gibbs.
Ian
W. All
right.
I like letters after me.
Sit.
Sit.
21-13, is it?
It's not 22.
No.
But did Nigel? But did Nigel have 21 more?
All right.
That's another win, Clive. Yeah. What's with the eyes?
Huh?
What's with the eyes?
No, not enough. No. Yeah, you can tell it's not quite enough. Nothing. No, probably.
And the roach are smaller, aren't they?
Yeah, small like 15, 16. Yeah.
Look, I have every one of them today. All of us have them. Everything. Yeah. Everything.
Pull it down here.
14. 15, yeah.
15 dead?
15 dead. Yes, okay, so probably about halfway today. My mate Clive Roberts, he won it, fair dues, £22. He won it last week as well, so on the same peg. Nigel, 21. And there's Jim Broccoli, £19, and Andy Thomas, 19-12. So, and but that was all up the one end, see? Yeah, that's where all the small roach were today. Anyway, that's it, so see you on the next one. Let's see if I do a bit better next week. Okay.